Hi Blender fans, and welcome to Blender TC. In today's tutorial, we're going to actually be looking at bump nodes. We're going to use this to actually make a silver foil tray, you know, the kind you get on jam tarts and pies and things like that. The reason we're doing this is because it really shows off well the bump node, or the bump map node. Let's begin. So what I'm going to do is quickly, I'm just going to add in a mesh, and the mesh we're going to add into is this circle. Right, the reason why we're adding a circle is because we're going to actually make this dish shape from that. And like I say, we're going to make a really low poly model, but we're going to add extra geometry, or it's going to seem to be adding extra geometry because of the bump map. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to edit mode by pressing the tab key. I'm going to extrude in slightly, just like so. I mean, if you want a reference image for this, you can download it in the description below, and the link will be below this tutorial. But what we're going to do is E and scale it down slightly. Oops, I've done that wrong. Control Z to undo. So E to extrude, S to scale. I'm just going to scale that down. E to extrude. And S to scale. In fact, I'm just going to extrude this down in the Z direction, just slightly, and then E, and then S, just to scale this down. G will move it down, like so. I'm just making a basic bowl shape, and extrude twice, one close because one's tight line there, and extrude again. And then F to fill. The reason we do two lines close to each other is because it actually prevents distortion. So if I go out of edit mode by pressing the tab key again, as you can see, if I spruce shade this, there is no distortion. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go on, you've got point select, line select, and face select here. I'm going to go on face select, press the alt key and left click, and that'll select the old ring. E and C, Control C, E and C, just to make a bit of a rim. So quickly and easily we've made ourselves a bowl shape, and as you can see, this is incredibly low poly. As you can see there is next to no polygons on this, and this is going to be a real simple shape. So I've smooth shade this, and what we're going to do now is we're going to add in a shader. So new, and we're just going to call this one oil, because that's what in effect we're going to make. So this is going to be made of foil. So we've got that. Obviously foil is made out of metal, so I'm going to make it metal, and I'm going to take the, in fact, I'm going to leave the roughness at 0.5, just like so. And I think I'm going to make this slightly, make this ridge slightly higher. So E, just to select that again, E and C, until the purple line appears. And there we go. So I've made myself that little folded rim you tend to get on the top of the silver foil trays. And now all we need to do is add our bump map to this item. So we've added our texture to this item, but what we're going to do now is add a base color, like so, and we're going to make an image texture. And then what I'm going to do is actually open the image texture, which I made earlier. Like I said, the actual image texture can be downloaded, link below. And I'm just going to select the place where I've saved this, which is my jam tart folder, and I'm just going to find the texture. And there's the texture. So I've got the texture, and now all we need to do is go into UV editing. So go into UV editing, make sure you're not in edit mode, and press the 7 key to look from the top. As you can see, if we actually move our mouse wheel on the left, this is the image that we're going to actually paste onto this item here, quite simply. And of course, we're going to actually use a bump map. So as you can see, that's a grayscale image, which makes a better bump map. But this one, I think it's got enough data so we can actually, because it's a grayish image anyway, we'll just use the actual color image we've got there. So press the tab key, go into edit mode, A to select all, and then what we're going to do is press the U key and then put project from view. As you can see, we've had this ring appear here, and just let me check this into rendered mode so you can actually see what we're actually dealing with. So what we've got here on the end, as you can see, I rolled these to the end with my mouse wheel, and what we've got there is we've got the image texture. So go to A, move this, or press the A key. If you double click on it or single click on it, it should go onto it. And we're just going to move this into the center like so. Scale it up like that. And as you can see, already we've got ourselves a image, but it's not a very realistic one. So I'm just going to add in now, I'm just going to come out of this. As you can see, the actual image is about right, but what we're going to do is go back into layout, go into the rendered version of it, and we're just going to add in a simple Hdri. So I'm going to go to the color, go to environmental texture, and then I'm going to open the Hdri, which I got from Polyhaven, which of course the link will be in the actual description down below as well for Polyhaven. Right, I'm going to set the Kaylee image, select the Kaylee image, and as you can see, that's now adding in a HDRI. And if I shade smooth this, as you can see, it doesn't look very realistic in that it just looks like a picture is just being stuck onto an item. Not very convincing whatsoever. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go into the shading tab, and I'm just going to move things around a little bit, zoom in on that, hold the shift and the actual central mouse button, just actually fetch it into view. And as you can see, that's just like, it's like it's been painted on. It's not very convincing at all. So G to move it over here. And this is where the actual beauty of the bump map actually comes into play. Oops. Let's move it up there. Right, so we're just going to add in a bump map. That was found under add vector, and as you can see, it's bump, and that adds in there. We'll connect that to the normal, and in between these, like I say, the bump map works better with an actual grayscale image or a black and white image. So we're just going to actually convert the color image to a black and white image. So just add a converter. And we're going to convert from RGB to BW, which of course stands for black and white. So select the color, go to the value, and we're just going to put this into the item map. Voila. And as you can see, this is already looking a lot like foil. But there's probably just one little bit that's missing. If I just take this down, I think that's just a bit too harsh. So what you do is go to the distance and just hit it just a tiniest little bit to make it look like foil. And I say the more you actually put this up, the more pronounced it becomes. And eventually, if you take it right up in the air, it looks a bit like welded metal. I'm just going to take this down to zero and then take it up by one, maybe two. And that's our file trait. And just one little other trick. You've got specularity. Adding specularity just makes it look that little bit more real, like that. So simply and easily, we've made ourselves, in fact, I'm going to take that back down again now. We've made ourselves a foil tray. And just to actually, as I've done it in the actual thumbnail, just actually give us a bit of a look. I'm just going to add in a mesh, and the mesh I'm going to add into is a sphere. I'm going to scale this down. We'll leave this in the center of the plate, shade smooth it. And if I add another material, just new, I'm just going to add a simple metal material. Take the roughness down from 50% to zero. And as you can see, quickly and easily, we've made ourselves a little foil tray with a steel ball bearing on top of it. And then simply just add in a plane, G and Z, just to move it down so it disappears, and then scale it up like that. So simply and easily, we've made ourselves a simple foil tray. And of course, if you want to actually make it a little bit smoother, this is done quite easily by just adding a subdivision modifier, subdivision surface modifier, which adds a bit more complexity to it. Shade smooth. But it still looks, I think it looked better as it was. Like that. And of course, here's the one I did earlier. Don't save. There's the one I did earlier. A little bit more work. I've just added a yellow light. But as you can see, it's basically the same thing. You've got specularity, the strength at 1, the 0.1 height, and it's pretty much the same as I've just showed you. All I've done is actually made it darker, I think. Anyway, thank you for watching our short tutorial to make our bump map on Blender TC. Join me next time when we'll look at maybe the tart itself. Maybe have a go at the tart itself, as it's actually in the image that you should have downloaded by now. Link below. Bye for now. And don't forget to subscribe.